আইনটা দেখিবাকু গলে মোটামুটি ছাড়পত্র আইন এ বিধায়ক যেটা কি আইন হব ইয়া পরে ইয়াকু আমি সমর্থন করছু আমি বিরোধ করুনু কিন্তু গোটিয়ে কে রহি যাচ্ছি আমি এটি বড় বড় আইন বিধায়ক সবু এটি আনিকিরি আলোচনা করিকিরি আমি তাকু লিপিবদ্ধ করে দেউছে কিন্তু বাস্তবরে তলস্তর যেহেতু ওড়িয়া ভাষায় কহিলা ঠু এটি ট্রান্সলেশন হউ নাহি এটি কেবল হিন্দি ভাষা ভাষী লোকঙ্কর দবদবা রহুছি এবং অন্য ভাষার লোকঙ্ক পাই স্থান নাহি সেটিপাই মু আপনঙ্ক ঠারু পারমিশন নে ইংলিশ রে মু ইংলিশ রে কইবাকু চাউছি
ম্যাম ফাইভ মিনিটস বিফোর ইউ হ্যাভ গিভেন
আই উইল স্পিক ইন ইংলিশ ম্যাডাম বিকজ দ্যাট ইজ
Yes, you can, but ek baat dhyan mein rakhe.
Only five I am starting,
minutes,
madam.
1 minute. Only 5 minutes before you have given.
So I am speaking in English.
That's why wo vyakti aane mein
no, I will speak in English, madam. No problem.
That's why it is happening.
I can, aisa mat bolo I am incoherent, but I will speak in English.
Dabdaba ya aisa kuch bhi nahi. It is not like
that. I will speak in English, madam.
Yes, come.
Madam, then that time is please may be deleted from my record. I am starting now. Thank you. You made me aware. I am grateful to you, madam. The same things I had said in Oriya, I am again repeating it in English. I am grateful to you, madam, for giving me this opportunity to speak on the Muslim Women Protection of Rights on Marriage Bill 2017, which is, in my understanding, in my comprehension, is basically focused on talaki bidet, and it is a chhadapatra, that means it is a divorce law. It affects one particular community in this country. We support the bill. We support this government in bringing this bill, but not the way it is intended to be applied at the ground level. This is, after about more than a decade, I am noticing, for over a decade, we have only been passing laws which affect the economy of this society or the country, all economy-related bills. This is one of the few socially relevant bills which this government has found time to bring, and therefore, with much pain, we are saying that we oppose this bill, like our floor leader, Sri Bharturi Mehtabji, raised it in the morning also. The opposition is very focused. We do not oppose the spirit. We are opposing the way you have introduced the criminality angle in this bill. Much has been spoken about Hindus and Muslims and Christians. I do not wish to delve into that. But this is divorce for what I have seen with my friends and my circle, those two or three instances of divorce that I have noticed, have been a very, very painful experience for the people involved. It is very easy for us to sit aside and pass a law. But I have seen how the woman involved in a divorce proceeding becomes a complete wreck after the proceedings are over. What trauma, if there are children in the family, what trauma the children have to go through, one has to see those to understand that this is not a flimsy thing where we can talk about you did this in 86, they did it in 56, we are doing it in 2017. It is not us and them always. It is we. We are the people. It is the Constitution says we the people of India. Here also, who are we? We are just representatives, mirrors of the people. So our opposition, which Mr. Mehtab raised in the morning, is about the way you intend to apply this this bill and this criminality aspect. This bill is definitely not an initiative of this government. All of us know about it. The Supreme Court, in a 3-2 judgment, created a necessity for the for this bill to be born. And we always pass bills, but we always seem to forget the implementation aspects, and that is where things are going wrong in this country. To claim that after the SC judgment on 22nd August 2017, and in spite of the AIMPLB giving an affidavit that no such further acts will happen, or they will advise their community members to refrain from talaq-e-bidat, out of some 300 odd such marriage annulments, 100 plus annulments happened after this Supreme Court judgment. That is what I came to know from the Honorable Minister. So it seems that very information spurred him, the Honorable Minister, and spurred the government to bring forth this bill. They deserve, the Supreme Court deserves the first kudos, and the government also deserves kudos for doing this yeoman act of bringing this bill. But then, in my usual thinking process, which is not always what everybody would like me to think in that fashion, I am wondering, a government that is so concerned to bring forth an ordinance to say that bamboo is not grass, bamboo is not a tree but is a grass, that same government did not feel it necessary to bring forth an amendment, or sorry, bring forth an ordinance in this particular case. If they could make a bamboo a grass or a tree, they could have made a Muslim into a Hindu into a Christian, or pass this as an ordinance. But this has no economic value. This is only the political twist to it. So therefore, this had to be debated, screamed about, and then the video can be shown everywhere that, look, these people are bad, those people are good. So the game is somewhere else. Here, I have a point of view. Bringing in criminality angle into, madam, that is why I say, I request you always with folded hands in the BSC, please give us some time, because the so-called major parties take away, you know, they gobble up all the time. And you are always kind, madam. You have always been. My point is that when we are talking about introducing this criminality aspect into this thing, into this divorce proceeding, this is a civil matter. And the moment you bring in a criminal aspect, and a man thinks, madam, I am talking not of the rich or the elite or ministers who believe in a particular religion sitting here. I'm not talking of that. I am talking of the poorest of the poor, may it be a Hindu, may it be a Muslim or a Christian, or no matter which religion. The poorest of the poor sees the law in very different angles. When you are refusing a person, a man or a woman, from staying with a partner, living with a partner, and there is compulsion by law that either you live together or you go to prison, madam, the resultant things could be brutal. There could be murders. There could be happenings which will be beyond the control of the government machinery. Because, like the Defamation Act, we saw this, madam, when we noticed that India is one of the few countries to have the criminal aspect in defamation, what has happened is that defamation is being misused in this country on a large scale. So when you bring in that same criminality aspect into the civil aspect of divorce law, you are creating situations where the government machinery will have no control. For example, if you see child marriage, don't we have a law against that? Dowry, don't we have a law against that? But are we able to claim as a society, not as politicians, as a healthy, vibrant society in India, are we able to claim that we have gotten rid of dowry, the evils of dowry? Have we the courage to stand up and say that yes, we have gotten rid of child marriage? If we cannot claim those things, what guarantee is there that this will stop talaq? Because when two souls cannot live together, how can law force something? How can law force anybody to share the same bed, to share the same roof, and share the same life? So, madam, whoever pronounces the word talaq three times goes to jail for 3 years. So I would suggest that whoever pronounces certain words in the Hindu system also should be imprisoned. I would not like to take the word here in the house. But you have to understand that our laws are only laws which are remaining on paper. Maybe India today can pride itself as having the highest per capita law amongst all countries on earth. When we are talking about regulation of the talaq law in the other countries, are we seeing what exact regulation they are doing? That is what I had asked also as a clarification. They have not banned. I am not saying we should copy some dark laws from other countries. That is not my point. My point is, whenever we are legislating anything that has a social impact, it is also our duty to see that the Hindu inspector of police, the Hindu magistrate, should not have anything whereby it can create a problem with a Christian or a Muslim or a Hindu. We should not laws.
Madam,
please listen.
I'm sorry. Don't
madam, please listen. What I'm saying, similarly, if it is a Muslim or if it is a Christian, the law, madam, let me finish. The law should be same for everybody. We cannot have laws for particular sects. The law of the land has to be equal for everybody, no matter what religion you are, no matter who you believe in or who...
Yes, Minister wants to say.
Madam, with the greatest respect to the Honorable Member, there is a tradition in this country that we have a trust in the judges.
Right.
Hindu judges hear cases of Muslim, and Muslim judges hear cases of Hindus.
Yes.
And some of the finest judgments about Hindu law have been given by Muslim judges, yes, and vice versa.
Yes.
I would urge him, at least on this, my state should not hear these matters. Yes. Let us not bring into that. That's what request
that
I'm making.
I am not making Hindu-Muslim divide. What I'm trying to say that the law cannot be enacted in such a manner. Madam, please listen to me. The law cannot be enacted in such a manner that it can be perverted at the implementation level. That is all I am saying. It does not matter whether it is a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian. For the lawmakers, everybody has to be equal. Everybody shall have the same rights. And every woman in this country, no matter which religion she professes, is equal or is higher than every male in this country in the eyes of the law.
Thank you. P. Ravindra Babu. No, Ravindra.